Hello everyone, welcome to HowFixit. If you're experiencing severe issues with your iPhone and suspect that the logic board is the culprit or you forgot your iCloud password, don't worry. I'm here to help. I'll show you how to replace the logic board, reviving your iPhone's functionality. Before we start disassembling, let me show you the tools you'll need. Screwdriver set. Plastic pry tools. Suction cup. Tweezers. Screen disassembly tool. Waterproof sealing tape. I have included links to all the tools and spare parts in the video description below. I also advise using a magnetic mat throughout the disassembly process, especially for repairing a device like an iPhone. While disassembling, manage each screw's placement to ensure accurate reassembly. And you don't have to worry about the screws getting lost. They will all securely adhere to the magnetic mat. So, let's get started. Turn off your iPhone and proceed to remove the two screws located near the charging port. Use a hairdryer to heat the bottom edge of the iPhone for approximately 1 minute, ensuring that the screen becomes slightly hot to the touch. Fix the suction cup to the screen's bottom edge and pull it up. Insert the blade into the thin gap between the screen and the chassis. From this position, gradually begin to separate the screen. The gap between the screen and the iPhone chassis is really small and hard to pry, which is why I consider this screen disassembly tool the most effective for safely removing iPhone screens. The adhesive holding the screen is quite strong, and the opening procedure requires some time. If you can't create a gap, heat the screen even more and gently separate the adhesive until you make a sufficient gap to insert a plastic spudger. To avoid damage to internal components, do not insert the tool deep into your iPhone. When opening the top of the iPhone case, avoid pushing the prying tool too deeply into the case to prevent damage to the components of the Face ID module. Open the screen with extreme caution. Make an effort to avoid sudden movements, because the screen is still connected to the main board. Abruptly separating the screen from the iPhone body can damage the screen cable. Remove the screws on the bracket securing the battery and display connectors. Remember, each screw has its place, so keep them organized for later reassembly. Use a plastic spudger to disconnect the battery cable. Next, disconnect the display cables and remove the screen. Replacing the logic board on the iPhone is a relatively quick process, taking around 15 minutes, and doesn't require any technical expertise. Follow the next steps. Disconnect all the cables from the logic board. Take out the SIM card tray and slide the SIM card eject piston back into the housing. Remove the screws securing the logic board in place. Gently remove the iPhone logic board from its housing. Here are some important things to keep in mind when replacing the logic board on your iPhone. If you want to retain the Face ID function on your iPhone with the logic board, you'll need to replace the Face ID module and the light sensor located on the display module. These components are interconnected through software and work as a pair. If you only change the logic board, Face ID will not work anymore. However, if you don't need face recognition to unlock your iPhone, you can replace only the logic board and keep the old module and sensors. In the video description below, I provided a link where you can find a replacement kit that includes a logic board with a Face ID module and cables with sensors. You can install a new logic board with any memory capacity you prefer. For example, if your iPhone has 256GB capacity, you can replace it with a logic board offering 512GB, or even 1TB. If your iPhone is locked due to iCloud issues, such as a forgotten password that can't be recovered, replacing the logic board gives you a fresh start, similar to having a new iPhone. Now that it's all back together, let's test the iPhone. After replacing the logic board, you may see the message that your iPhone has a non-genuine Apple battery. The good news is that this message is not critical, and your device will work fine. Let's proceed with the final step of assembly and restoring water protection. Remove old adhesive tape from your iPhone's case. Use isopropyl alcohol and a cotton swab to remove any remaining smaller bits of adhesive. Carefully align the edge of the adhesive tape with the iPhone case. Use a spudger to press all the adhesive into place and around the entire perimeter of your iPhone. Grab the small pull tab and peel the front liner from the adhesive. Press the display around the entire perimeter to secure its position. Then, fasten the last two screws located near the charging port. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tips and guides. Visit our website for more tech insights and do-it-yourself guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. Well done, the repair is now complete. You were on How Fix It, and see you again next time.